subscribe and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from radioandmusic.com.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good too.
Nice.
Well, we heard your song, Tejal, Khali Khali. You know, the song is beautifully sung and composed and it's done by you. And it's got good, views and, you know, it's people appreciating the song. So, you know, how was the making process of it? Like, how did you begin, you know, with this project?
Thank you. The response has been really good, actually. I've been getting DMs and people are using it in reels. People have posted reaction videos on YouTube and it's not even been a full day. So, I'm quite like, overwhelmed, and I mean, I'm just like, wow, this is so cool. And in terms of the process, I actually, during this lockdown, I was just doing my music lessons and just focusing on my content, taking a step back to, you know, just see what I actually like to do instead of just being in a rush. So I was doing that, and while practicing another song for my music class, I just started humming, and I was thinking of this really beautiful moment that I had about, you know, with the people you love and who are really special to you. You don't have to do anything amazing to have a good time with that person. You don't have
right.
You just sit and chill, and you just sit like empty, and that's really, really sweet. So that's what was in my head, and I just started writing, started singing, and in half an hour I had a song, which is really crazy. I didn't know that I could do something like that. And it was cool. I sent it to my friends, my brother, and everyone told me that this is a good song. You should like do it. And in 2 weeks, I had the video and everything done as well. So actually, when we did the shoot, like I paid for the whole thing on my own.
Yes. Like for all your technicalities and everything, right?
Yeah. And we shot it like a professional huge music video with like a proper cinematic camera.
Right.
So I like, you know, I wanted to make it really special. So got all this like cool crew and talented people to make the video. But I paid for it myself, that I'm super proud of, that, you know, like I'm able to, because I started from making like style on a budget videos with like 500 rupees. And now it feels really cool that a few years later I can sponsor a huge project for myself. So
right.
So that's really cool. And it was a cool experience. But of course I was scared. I was like, what if this camera breaks? Then I don't know what I'm going to do. But it was nice. I felt really cool. Okay.
Yeah, it was a super cool. Expensive camera.
Yeah.
After all. Right, so you know, your last song was Aisi Hu, right?
Yeah.
And this song is Khali Khali. So two songs in the pipeline you've had. So which more songs are you gonna, like, are you bringing in more songs?
Yeah, actually, like, I have one more. I'll keep posting more. So I'm working on a few. One of them is ready. So I guess in a few months, you'll see that as well.
Right.
Yeah.
So are we seeing you in a different space right now, like making more music, like singing to more music? So were you always inclined to music, and how did it all happen? Like, you know, how did you get into music? Like, do you have a family background which is into music or something?
So I've actually always been into performing. I've grown up singing, and I've grown up learning dance, being on stage. And YouTube and fashion is just something I'm so passionate about, and that's my content. And I always approach it like this, and I always try to mix it up with my other hobbies, you know, like music and acting and singing. And thankfully, it's been really cool. I've gotten the chance to act in a web series as well, which is now on Netflix. So it's cool that us creators, we get to explore a lot of different things. But in terms of music, yeah, actually music has been around me since I was a kid. My brother is a guitar player and a singer. I mean, by profession, he's an investment banker, but he's been playing guitar all his life. My mom's actually an amazing singer. She's so much better than
lovely.
I am. Yeah, she's really, really good. And my cousin brother is a jazz drummer. So it's always been in the house. We always jam, and we always, I've been helping my brother write songs since I was a kid, and just sing along when he would play the guitar, singing in school, college. So it's always been like that.
Nice. You know, so you have launched your YouTube channel, Tejal, in 2014. And from there onwards, you know, we've seen a huge change. you know, in your videos and, you know, the new content that you bring in. So what are the changes you have seen in yourself, you know, over these 7 years?
It's been a while since I've been making content, and it feels really cool because I started out when I was so young. I was 19 when I posted my first video, and I think that's like I was just in college, like any other regular college kid. And I always had big dreams that I want to. I used to keep giving auditions, but obviously getting rejected clearly. But I always wanted to do something creative, and I had no way to do it but through YouTube. And I thought, wow, it's cool, I can do it on my own. And I guess the change that I've seen in myself is that I've become a lot smarter, and I've become a lot more, like, I think I'm really good at my job, both creative-wise and both business-wise. And I take a lot of pride in that because I think I'm an independent woman now, running my own business, making my own money, running a team, and still being creative and being as authentic as I can. So I think that's what I've learned, that I'm dope and I'm doing good and I need to move it. So I think that's been the biggest change that I've seen in myself. So super proud of that.
Amazing, amazing. So you know, you drop a lot of content online. Sejal, I wanted to ask you this one thing. I'm sure you must be getting feedbacks, and definitely there may be some people who must be trolling you and all. So how do you deal with all of this? You know, there's this space called social media negativity. So how do you deal with that?
I mean, I actually talk about it a lot. I posted this small reel on Instagram recently. I do a fashion series on Instagram called What I Wore. And in this one, you usually see me smiling, making goofy faces and doing all that. But in this one, I look so sad. And because I had just read a couple of comments right before I started filming, and they really hurt my feelings. Like, obviously, this is some mean stuff. And
right,
it hits your insecurity, it really hurts. So instead of telling myself, chal, camera's on, smile, I was like, nahi ho raha yaar mujhse. And I can't be like, I can't fake stuff. Like, I don't want to fake. And in that video, like, when I saw it play back, I was like, wow, this is so sad. I feel like this is like actual real emotion. And I put it up, and the response is really, it's really interesting and impactful. All the comments. Right. People are encouraging me, some people are still trolling me, but it was really cool to see that if you put your real emotion out there, it always gets a good response from people.
Right, so you have put your real emotions out here, you know, as you always do in your videos. So how much of a pressure do you feel while creating content and while delivering it? Like, do you have this constant thinking, you know, like, will people like it, will people not like it? What are the comments that, you know, will I get? All of those things do you have it.
Yeah, totally. Like, that thing keeps going in your head all the time. Like, because if people comment on things like, Sejal, you're being arrogant, Sejal, you're being rude, whatever. So every time you talk on camera, those things will be in your head.
Yes.
But I'm trying to consciously not be like that anymore, because living by what a couple of comments said about me is so, it's just, it's not healthy. So yeah, it's a difficult thing to do. I'm still a young person, still trying to, you know, grow up and find myself. So
of course,
I'm just going to keep working on that. But at the same time, I feel like I'm able to handle all this negativity a little bit better than I could when I was younger.
Right, right. You know, so you have been a part of this project called Creators for a Change. You know, so when your fans meet you, you know, they must be telling you a few things, like, you know, how you have changed their lives, or, you know, how you motivate them. So, you know, what are those comments that have really, you know, you felt very enlightened, you felt very nice about it?
Yeah, actually, that
it changed your day, you know, that particular comment or that particular person changed your day.
Yeah, it's actually really nice that you asked, because there are so, we always talk about the haters and the trolling kind of people, but there are so many people who take their time to write such sweet things. I'm just like, why would you do that? You know, it's so kind. Like, I you know, it's so selfish, like, to put a nice comment on someone else's work. So it's really, really sweet.
Right.
But I guess with that song only, Aisi Hoon, this Creators for Change project that I did, I was depicting this middle class Indian girl who has all sorts of restrictions that any regular girl in our country has, and the response to that was so real and insane because it opened my eyes up to how so many girls actually live. Yeah. I'm lucky that my parents are supportive and they have made me an independent person, but sadly it's not the case for so many girls. And when I read those comments, it just made me feel like, wow, like there's so many girls out here who, like, I wish I could help, you know?
Yeah, right. Also, your new song is doing amazing. So, you know, what is the feedback you've got from your family, friends, and, you know, your colleagues, your office colleagues? What are they saying about it?
Really good. Everyone's just saying, so cute, it's so cute, it's so cute, and it's so catchy. So that's the number one thing. Literally, that's it. It's so cute, yeah. It's so catchy.
Yeah, it's very cute.
It's catchy. So that's huge for me. I'm just like, wow, this is cool.
Right. So any advice, or, you know, you of course must have done riyaz and all before singing the track. So anything, you know, the special memories that you made while making this track?
Special memories. So my music producer is actually my childhood friend. I've known him since I was in class one, and he's always encouraged me to sing. His name is Saptak. He's a musician himself, Saptak Chatterjee. He's funny as hell. So while recording the track, there's bits of it in my vlog as well. We're just laughing at dumb stuff and just like making the jokes throughout the recording process. So that is my most fun memory. And also, we had a really cute dog in the music video. So that dog was really fun to film with, like peed in my room and everything. It was really fun.
Thank you so much, Sejal, for, you know, your time and for this amazing interview and your insights.
Thank you.